Hi, everybody. First of all, thanks so much for coming out this evening. We just want to start by giving Justin and Ben and the team a huge shout out for having us here and also hosting the AI Day. We are really excited to be here tonight to introduce you to Ada, the Digital Assistant for Smarter Business. Now, we at Ada, we truly believe that small business is the backbone to our economy. And if small businesses are doing well, then it's probably a good indication of the overall health of the economy. So you know what? Let's give these guys a hand. We've developed Ada to give small business owners access to the latest technology, giving them real-time insights into their business data. And what's really, really cool about Ada is that these insights are delivered the same way you and I would communicate, through conversation. So with that, I am Hayley Clinning. I am one part of our amazingly diverse and talented team based here in Auckland. I'm originally from South Africa, but a Kiwi at heart, and I love the outdoors, which how could you not in our awesome country? And yeah, I'm a data scientist by trade, so finding actionable insights from data is something that I'm really passionate about.
Thanks. And I'm Carrie Vickers. I'm the newest recruit at Ada. I'm the head of marketing. I'm fresh off the boat from Canada. I've been here for 4 weeks. And I've gotten the full Kiwi experience since I've been here. So I've been boating off the coast of Waiheke. I did some fishing, which was amazing. I jumped on one of those Lime scooters and proceeded to massively crash that scooter. And I have the scars to prove it. Oops. And I've drank a lot of coffee, and literally the best coffee in the world. So thanks for that warm welcome, New Zealand. I've had a pretty lengthy career, and most recently I served for another AI company based in North America, and that was a really amazing experience. And when I met the founders of Ada, I was really excited by what they're doing for small business. I come from a family of all small business owners. Pretty much everyone in my family owns a small business, and that's what I grew up with. So I really believe in what they're doing and that it's absolutely game-changing. So I want to walk you through what an Ada customer looks like and the problems that we're solving. So we're going to use this persona. This is Fletch. Fletch is a really cool guy. He's a bit of a hipster. He's a husband and a father. He's a family guy. He owns a great cafe, and it's got 3 different locations, and he's growth-focused. So he wants to grow that business. He currently has 20 employees and growing, so he's hiring. So if anyone's looking for a barista job, you know where to go. He likes to make data-led decisions. So he's got his business in the cloud, which is great. He's a little more advanced technologically, and sometimes it's just not that easy to do. So we'll take a closer look at his tech stack. So he's got a point of sale system. He uses Counta. He uses iPayroll. He uses beautiful accounting software called Xero. He relies on social media to do a lot of his marketing and to build his community. He's got a great website, and he uses Deputy for rostering. So what's the problem? So Fletch, like most small business owners, is time poor. So he does all the jobs. He wears all the hats. He's not just the business owner. He's also the head of marketing. He's the sales guy. He's the HR department. So he does it all. He's an ideas guy as well. So he's got a lot of questions, but it's not so easy to get answers. So like I said, he's got all of these different data sources, but they're all siloed. So if he's got questions and he requires data, he needs to sign into each system. He needs to extract data, put it into a spreadsheet sometimes, do the math in order to do analysis. And that's not rocket science. Anyone can do that, but it definitely takes time. And so he quite often doesn't do that at all. So instead, he'll consult his peers, and that's subjective advice, which may or may not be good. Or he makes gut decisions, or no decisions at all. And we really think this is a big risk for small business owners, and that's why we're doing what we're doing. So this puts Fletch into a jam, and quite often he wants to crawl into a hole and hide. So I'm sure lots of people have felt that same way here, and this is it's a game-changing opportunity for conversational AI and natural language understanding. This is the problem that we are solving. So if you can imagine, Fletch is in his car. He's going to pick up his kids, and he's able to ask questions of his data from wherever he is. That's pretty powerful. Maybe even better, Fletch literally hasn't taken a vacation in a long time because he's so busy working in his business. What if he could have just as much information and take just as much action in his business from the beach in Fiji? That would be pretty amazing.
Well, Fletch, we have good news for you. You can book that holiday that you are wanting to take, and you can do it right now because meet Ada, your digital assistant for smarter business. Ada is your AI-first, mobile-first business assistant that is with you at any time and anywhere and gives you access to your business data in real time as if you were talking or texting with another person. So by bringing all of Fletcher's multiple data sources into one easy-to-use place, he can make those data-led decisions that he's been wanting to. He can get the insights to make those decisions. He can take actions from insights that he not only asks about, but also that the insights that Ada sends to him proactively. He can schedule those insights that are most important to him, as well as ask Ada to remind him about his really long to-do list. And what's more is he can actually share the insights that he receives from Ada with other people who he thinks should know about what's going on in his business. What's really cool about Ada is Fletch can simply go to the App Store or Google Play, download Ada, sign up, connect his business apps, and ask away. He can get instant insights. So with less than a few minutes, Fletch is able to connect his multiple data sources to the Ada engine. And one thing that we're really working on here is how do we make this conversation between Fletch and Ada as human-like as possible? Well, we're using a technique known as natural language understanding, or NLU. So in the back end of the Ada engine, Ada is ingesting the questions that Fletch is asking. Ada is then trying to identify the underlying intent so Ada can really understand what is actually being asked. And once Ada is confident that the intent is understood, the data source or data sources that are required to answer that question are brought together. A message is generated and sent back to Fletch in an easy-to-understand format. So by Fletch bringing Ada on board to his team, he gets his own AI assistant that is fluent in small business language. He gets all of his apps connected in one place, and he also gets access to a number of built-in apps that are already available with Ada, and that's things like weather and events. This is to help Fletch understand how outside events can actually affect his business as well. And all of this is available through voice and text. He can get alerts, set reminders, and really make those smarter business decisions that he wants to. Ada really has this cool and unique opportunity because a lot of these capabilities and technology will be new to its users. So we take them on what we call a journey through their data. And we start with what we call vanity metrics. And these are simple insights or answers that Ada can feed back to Fletch, which Fletch can actually go and confirm for himself. So he gets an answer for his weekly sales so far, and Ada can deep link him into his counter dashboard, and he can really confirm those numbers. And this is an opportunity for Ada to really build that trust that is needed. Next, Ada can perform cross-app analysis to help Fletch understand why things have happened in this business. So rather than Fletch going out and extracting all that data, merging it together and connecting all the dots, Ada does this for him. So here we've had a spike in sales, and oh yeah, it's because last month Fletch ran a social media campaign giving away a free coffee with every meal purchased. Hello, who doesn't love a free coffee? And next, Ada thinks, oh, I wonder if Fletch has actually realized he's had a record number of website visits, and most of these visitors are new. Well, Ada sends out these proactive insights through what we call Did You Knows. And these are what Ada considers useful truths that Fletch probably hasn't thought to ask about, but it's probably good for him to know. So we send out these Did You Knows. And lastly, we have Ada's predictive capabilities. How cool would it be for Fletch to get a glimpse into his future sales so he can plan ahead and be on the front foot? Well, now he can. So with Fletch now having access to all these different insights, he's really able to plan ahead and actually take action within Ada and within his business. So Do you want to rerun that voucher campaign? Sure, let Ada do that for you. Do you want to pay an upcoming invoice that's due? Sure, let Ada do that for you. But what's really important to understand here and be aware of is that none of this is magic. Ada is simply applying machine learning to Fletcher's business data and the questions that he's asking. It's then producing an outcome for artificial intelligence to make a decision upon. And the flow-on effect from this is Fletch receives these insights and he's able to make smarter business decisions, which in turn creates more data. And yeah, you get the gist. It's a constant learning loop where artificial intelligence is being used to improve human intelligence. And Ada is here to help people like Fletch make those smarter business decisions with his own AI assistant that is backed by his own business data.
Thanks. So yeah, that's all really exciting and interesting for small business owners. But as a SaaS AI company startup, there's definitely a lot of challenges that we face. So I just wanted to talk a little bit about those. So adopting AI technology, it's definitely the era of AI, and basically every SaaS company and their dog claims to have AI technology. So that's challenging when it comes to a customer perspective, because they may or may not have had a previous bad experience, or they have a different perception. So that's something that we have to work with. There's also all the fear-mongering that we hear about AI, and that's something that we face as an AI company as well. But it's actually been pretty amazing for us, because our early adopters are already in the cloud. So I want to say a thank you to anyone who has had a SaaS company in the last number of years that has been tasked with getting people to adopt the cloud, because you really did pave the way for me. The next thing is, once we get someone into AI and using it, we need to really be cognizant of getting that conversation flowing. So it's a disruptive technology. Business owners have never had this ability to engage with their data in this way. So we need to help them learn what to ask. So we do a lot of this in Ada. So we give them conversation starters. So all of the different integrations we have, we give them a list of questions that help get the dialogue flowing. And Haley touched on a couple of the other things we do, like did you knows and that kind of thing. And that's kind of an ongoing process. And that leads right into my next point about constant tangible education. What we're really trying to do here is help small businesses grow their business. So we need to educate them on what kinds of questions they should be asking. So maybe a retail business wants to grow their profits during their downtime or their low season. So it's our job to educate them on how they can potentially do that, or what questions they need to ask in order to make certain decisions. And finally, from a development perspective, keeping a clean and simple user interface. So one of Ada's main differentiators is it's super simple to use, and it's a really friendly user interface. So we want to keep it that way. If you know how to text, you know how to use Ada. So we have very visionary founders and a really amazing team that's always got ideas, and we're always adding things and growing it and adding integrations and features. So we really have to be cognizant, and we keep this as a principle of Ada, that keeping it clean and simple is the way we go. So simple is not always easy. So let's bring it back to Fletch. So if you remember at the beginning, I asked you to imagine Fletch being able to ask questions of his data from wherever he is. So maybe he's at the gym or in his car or on the beach in Fiji. So with that, we're really excited about our recent integration with Alexa, so Amazon Alexa, and we're working on several other integrations with voice assistants. So I got tasked with showing you this. So. So we're going to give it a go. So we've got an Alexa device here. Alexa, open Ada.
Welcome to Ada, the digital assistant for your small business. Ask me about your financial, marketing, operational, or people data, or even external data that may help you.
Give me my business report.
Today's information so far is revenue $1,343, cost of sales $765. Website traffic is 201 visitors. You have 3 new Facebook followers. One person didn't turn up for work today, and your payroll is due tomorrow for a total of $15,500. Ask me more about these metrics individually if you'd like to.
Tell me about my website traffic.
Today's website traffic information is 201 visitors, of which 180 are new. They visited 15 of your pages with an average session duration of 4.5 minutes. Your goal conversion rate is 15%.
Tell me about today's roster.
Today's roster information is, of the 4 people rostered to work today, 3 turned up on time. Would you like to notify the people on your standby list to see who can come in?
Yes, please.
I have actioned this through the Deputy app and your standby list will be notified.
So as you can see, that's amazing because it doesn't always understand me that well. as you can see, that's really powerful for a small business owner to have that kind of access to their information in that way. So smarter business has arrived. So we are a New Zealand-based company, and we are really getting traction here in New Zealand, and we're growing globally, and we really want to take this company to another level. So I'm sure there's many people here in the room who have friends like Fletch, so my call to action to you is to please give Aider a try and recommend Aider to your friends, and we're happy to offer a 30-day free trial. So check us out, and thank you. Enjoy the rest of the conference.